Welcome to this Agilent ESOF EDA demo, Layout, Line Types in ADS. The Advanced Design System Layout Editor is an integrated tool for creation of RF printed circuits and ICs. It's also a powerful polygon editor. There are 7 distinct line types. There are lines to aid in the construction of shapes and lines to establish connectivity. There are also lines for use in documentation, but those will not be discussed here. Let's look at the line types now. Polylines are base multi-segment lines of zero width. To place one, choose the icon in the toolbar and click in the layout. Each click adds a vertex, double-clicking ends the polyline. The snap commands are helpful here. If you wanted to bisect this rectangle, for instance, choose the line midpoint snapping, and you'll notice that it goes right from one midpoint to the other to bisect a rectangle. Edge snapping allows you to work with any edge, for instance this point, to the edge of, say, a circle, which could lie off-grid. We also have arc and circle snapping, which finds the center point, and here we connect the two circles using that. We also have commands for finding vertices and intersection points between lines. So here I can start where this line intersects this circle, and then go to where this polyline intersects this polygon. Construction lines are handy lines for drawing and aligning objects in the layout. You insert them using the insert construction line command. You select a starting point and then select a direction that you wish your construction line to be in. Here's one, and we'll create a second one in this other direction. You'll notice that these lines extend to infinity. That's because they're only used as guidance and they are not part of your actual design. We will use the polygon command and use the construction lines for aligning the polygon that we wish to create. We have all our snap modes turned on, and now we can begin entering segments for our polygon. You notice that the snap allows the cursor to snap right to the construction line. We can enter the segments that we need, and we see that the polygon is drawn in perfect alignment to our construction lines. We can create arrays like this that are at any angle yet perfectly aligned. We will now discuss paths and traces. A path is a multi-segmented line with properties of width, length, and corner type. They're typically used to interconnect parts of a design that aren't being simulated, for instance, DC bias lines. We can enter them using the path icon and filling out the parameters in the path menu, for instance, the corner type. In this case, we'll use a mitered corner, set the mitered corner properties and our line width, and then we begin entering it using our cursor. The delta readout shows us the length of each segment, while the cumulative readout shows the length of all the segments put together. We end a path by double-clicking in the layout. Let's change corner types, and we'll create a new path with a new corner type, dismissing the menu to give us more screen real estate for viewing our layout. Trace is similar to a path with a notable distinction. Traces have nodes that assign connectivity between components. You can insert a trace using the trace icon, which is located in the toolbar in the same location you find the wire icon on a schematic toolbar. The trace menu has the same controls as the path menu, and we can insert a trace by clicking between nodes. I'm not going to worry right now exactly what path my trace takes because I can always select the vertex and move it anywhere I wish to. Occasionally, we come across situations where we want to insert a trace of a given length between two points. Here, I'll use the insert meander trace command that ADS provides for doing just that. The menu includes the same controls that we have for a path, with additional controls for defining the direction we wish the meander line to take. Now I will insert one of these between the capacitor shown here and the transistor. you'll see that we have a ghosted image showing the direction the meander line will take. Traces can be represented in the schematic in three different ways. The convert trace command allows us to simulate the trace as either a single transmission line equaling its total length, multiple transmission line elements including the bend discontinuities, or an ideal nodal connection. This concludes our presentation of line types in ADS. We've looked at polylines and construction lines that help us create shapes, and we've looked at paths and traces to help us establish connectivity. Lines to assist us in documentation are discussed in a different demonstration. Thank you, and we wish you success in your designs. To see more demos, visit our website and sign up for our email newsletter to find out about new ones as they become available.